Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your current affairs through MCQ mode. So today is 6th November, so let's see what are the questions for today. So the first question is, Skill Build platform launched by Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship is in collaboration with A. Microsoft, B. Infosys, C. IBM, D. Tesla. So we have to choose that which of these is correct. Let me tell you friends that the answer is C, that is IBM. So this Ministry of Skill Development has and Entrepreneurship has launched Skill Build platform, and it is in collaboration with IBM. So key facts are, it is launched by Directorate General of Training under the aegis of Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So as a part of this program, a 2-year advanced diploma in IT networking and cloud computing co-created and designed by IBM will be offered at the ITIs, that is Industrial Training Institutes and National Skill Training Institutes. So significance is that digital platform will provide a personal assessment of cognitive capabilities and personality via My Inner Genius to the students. So they will then learn foundational knowledge about digital technologies as well as professional skills such as resume writing, problem solving and communication. So this is more detail you can check by pausing the video. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, which article of the Indian Constitution provides for the prevention of concentration of wealth? A. Article 39, B. Article 40, C. Article 38, D. Article 44. So friends, answer is clearly A. So this is asked in the context of an editorial that had appeared in yesterday's newspaper of The Hindu, that is a rights-based framework to theorize poverty. So solution is A. So it basically enjoins the state to make effort so that the wealth is not concentrated in the hands of few people. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following are free trade partners of India? First Asian, second Japan, third South Korea, fourth China. So we have to choose that which of these is correct. Let me tell you friends that only first, second and three are correct. So answer is C. With China we don't have free trade agreement, so certainly that would be a kind of, we can say, big blow to our indigenous manufacturing capabilities. So RCEP negotiation, you might be aware of that it was going on in Bangkok, Thailand, and then India has decided that India will not join it. So major free trade agreements that India has implemented so far include South Asia Free Trade Agreement, Indo-Asian Comprehensive Economic Cooperation Agreement, Indo-Korea, India-Korea, and then India-Japan. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, Siddha medicine is practiced in which of the following regions? A. Kannada region, B. Telugu region, C. Tamil region, D. Malayalam region. So friends, answer is C, that is Tamil region. So fusing traditional medicine with the modern, this is in context of the editorial. So it is one of the oldest systems of medicine in India. So it means achievements and Siddhas were saintly persons who achieved results in medicines. So 18 Siddhas were said to have contributed to its development. And it is basically, this literature is in Tamil and it is practiced largely in Tamil speaking part of India and abroad. So Siddha system is largely therapeutic in nature. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following traditional healthcare practices is not followed in India? A. Homeopathy, B. Yunani, C. Soa Rigpa, D. None of the above. So this is a quite easy question, so answer is clearly C. So Soa Rigpa is basically, it is a Tibetan system of medicine. So it is one of the oldest living and well documented medical tradition of the world. So it has been originated from Tibet and now it is popularly practiced in India, Nepal, Bhutan, Mongolia and Russia. So though India is not India is not the source of originator of this system of medicine, but though the practice of Soa Rigpa is quite similar to Ayurveda. So Ayurveda, so first Ayurvedic influence came to Tibet during 3rd century AD, but it became popular only after 7 centuries with the approach of Buddhism to Tibet. So more details you can check by pausing the video. So now let's move to the next question. Next is trouble burning becomes necessary when paddy crop is harvested using combine harvesters. Second, turbo happy seeder is a solution to counter stubble burning in Punjab. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is are correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. So stubble burning, it is a common practice followed by farmers to prepare fields for sowing of wheat in November, as there is little time left between harvesting of paddy and sowing of wheat. So stubble burning, you might be aware of the fact that newspapers have reported a very worse quality of air in Delhi specifically, and in other cities as well of North India. So concern is basically the farmers do not have alternatives. So they cannot afford new technology that is available to handle the waste material, and experts say that with less income due to crop damage, farmers are likely to be inclined to light up their fields to cut costs and not spend in scientific ways of stubble management. So advantages is it quickly clears the field and is cheapest alternative, and it also kills weed including those resistant to herbicide, and then slugs and other pests get killed and can reduce nitrogen tie-up. So then obviously you might be aware of the fact that it has adverse impact on air quality. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is polypedates Bengal linensis seen in news is related to A. frog species, B. bird species, C. plant species, D. none of the above. So friends, let me tell you the answer is A, that is frog species. So polypedates Bengal linensis, it is a newly discovered frog species from West Bengal, or it is also known as brown blotched Bengal tree frog. So it belongs to the genus polypedates. There are 25 other polypedate species around the world, and this one is 26th. So body color is yellowish brown to greenish brown, so you can see it. So now let's move to the next question. Next is ice dash and Atithi seen in news is related to A. Antarctic outpost, C. B. customer clearance, C. unmanned aircraft, D. none of the above. So friends, let me tell you, answer is B. So Atithi, you might get some idea about it by its name. So two new IT initiatives, that is Ice Dash and Atithi, have been launched for improved monitoring and pace of customs clearance of imported goods and facilitating arriving international passengers. So Ice Dash is an ease of doing business monitoring dashboard of Indian customs, helping the public see the daily customs clearance times of the import cargo at various ports and airports. And Atithi app is basically hassle-free and fast. It is for hassle-free and faster clearance by customs at the airport, and enhance the experience of international tourists and other visitors at the airport. Now let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements. First, NBFCs are required to maintain cash reserve ratio with the Reserve Bank of India. Second, recently RBI has proposed to introduce liquidity coverage ratio to further improve the resilience of the NBFC to liquidity problems. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is are correct. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is B. So NBFCs are not required to keep cash reserve ratio, but now it has introduced, RBI has introduced liquidity management framework for non-banking financial companies. So guidelines are applicable to applicable to all non-deposit taking NBFCs with an asset size of 100 crore and above. And this systematically important care investment companies and all deposit taking NBFCs irrespective of their asset size. So it was necessary to strengthen their asset liability management following the liquidity crisis that is currently faced by them, specifically in the past year. So specific cap on negative asset liability mismatches for particular liquidity buckets. So NBFCs are now mandated to maintain liquidity coverage ratios. It will promote resilience of NBFCs to potential liquidity disruptions. So more details you can check by pausing the video. So this is quite lengthy explanation, so that will consume a lot of time. And now let's move to the last question of the day. Last is regional comprehensive economic agreement. Seen in news is between ASEAN and A 10 countries, 6 countries, 15 countries, none of the above. So friends, answer is quite easy. It is 6 countries. So this is basically, this was going on in Thailand. So Thailand, that is Bangkok, and India has decided not to join it. So it has expressed concerns over lowering and elimination of tariffs on products from other countries, as it could affect our domestic agricultural as well as manufacturing sector. So there are multiple reasons that why India has not signed. So you can check more detail by pausing the video. So it is quite lengthy explanation. So this question has been picked up from basically Indian Express explained part. So friends, this is all about your today's video relating to daily current affair MCQs. So if you like this video, if you like the discussion, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly friends, we also have our Telegram channel where we have more than 14,000 subscribers. So you can visit this Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and it will also be provided in the description box. So here on this Telegram channel, what we do, we share various public resources for CSE preparation, and if you are willing to get access of those resources, you can join this Telegram channel, and link will be there in description box. And you can also contact us at achieveias21@gmail.com or 8968920720 in case of any queries, doubts. So your queries, doubts are most welcome. And this is all about today's video. Do ensure that you subscribe to our channels. Thank you friends, have a very nice day ahead.